Hey guys, it's Mickey, and today we're going to bleed the brakes on my 1992 Honda Civic SIR-S. Lately, the pedal's been feeling a little squishy, and the brakes haven't been bled, and the fluid hasn't been changed in a long time. So today, we're going to upgrade to some Motul fluid and bleed all four brake corners and see if we can get the pedal stiff again. So there's a few different methods to bleeding your brakes. We're actually going to use the brake fluid bleeder method that's pneumatic. So we're going to utilize my air compressor. This is like a replica bleeder from Harbor Freight, but seems to work pretty well. I've used it on a clutch line and had good luck with it. So basically what it is you've got a filler bottle, some extra parts that come with it to sit this in the filler or in the reservoir, and it has a valve to open it up so that you don't have to stand there and have somebody with you all the time putting fluid in. So that's a pretty handy thing to have. This is the actual pneumatic bleeder that you put onto the brake bleeder valve and then run the air compressor, which creates vacuum and pulls the air out through the lines. I've already went ahead and drained as much of the fluid out of the reservoir as possible. You can use either like an old turkey baster, or I just actually used some clean rags and soaked up whatever I didn't need in there, and removed the filter and cleaned it so that when I put it back in, there's no stuff in it. Only tool you'll probably need is a 10 mil for the bleeder valves, which I have here, and some brake fluid. We're going to go with the Motul 5.1, which is a really good brake fluid, and it can be mixed with dot 3 or 4, which I have dot 4 in here already, so the little bit that it's going to mix with is compatible. So here we go. So we've removed the wheel and we've got the reservoir filled with the new fluid. So now I'm going to hook up the air compressor to the pneumatic bleeder valve and go ahead and put the head of the pneumatic bleeder onto the actual bleeder. Maybe I will. It's tight, so this airtight. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take our 10 millimeter and we're going to depress the trigger on the gun here to basically create vacuum in the system. But we want to do that while the valve is closed. So we'll start by pulling this, opening the valve, so you start seeing fluid come out. But there is a ton of air in the system. And you can tell that there's air in the system by the amount of bubbles going through the clear hose. Pulling out the old fluid at the moment. So we got thrown a curveball. We went ahead and hooked up the pneumatic bleeder to the rear left brake caliper, which is the furthest from the master cylinder because it's a right-hand drive car. And it was pulling vacuum, and we're getting fluid, but tons of air. I've never seen this much air. So we decided to go with the old-fashioned bottle and clear rubber hose method. And right away we were able to see a big air bubble come through the hose. So we bled it a few times, went ahead and moved on to the right rear side, same thing. I don't know if the pneumatic air bleeder is just faulty, or I don't know, maybe I'm just not using it correctly. Seems like a fairly simple system to use. We'll blame it on human error. We won't say it's a pile of crap. We're just gonna go with the old school method and do it right. So we made it to the last corner. It's actually bleeding really smoothly with the old school method, which is the clear tube and bottle. So as long as you have an extra person with you pushing down the pedal, so we're doing 5 pedal strokes, cracking the valve, watching the air come out, and then closing the valve and doing it over again until we don't see any air come out. So this is actually going to be the last one here, so he's going to go ahead and pump the pedal 5 times. 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to crack the valve and we should see air go into the bottle. There, now we see that we've got a clean line, no air coming out. I can seal it off. And I like to do it just one more time for good measure to make sure there's nothing hung up in the caliper. So 5 more. Open the valve. We've got actually no flow, so it's basically good to go. All right guys, so we got the car buttoned up, wheels are back on. It's time to go for a test drive and make sure we did a good job on these brakes. After the test drive, as long as the brakes are feeling stiff or firm and the car's stopping good, we know we've done a nice job. If we haven't, we just repeat the process of what we already did. Subscribe to our page to see what we're up to and follow our how-tos.